Well, hello everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Star Wars Battlefront 2 Modded. I am Adrien, and in today's video we're taking a look at Renz's, Coruscant's the one we're looking at next, Mos Eisley, which is basically an attempt at making an accurate Mos Eisley from, Star Wars Episode 4, and it does a lot better job than the, original stock map. It tries to recreate a lot of the, some of the memorable locations from the movie, and as well as, you know, adhering to at the time, canon map of Mos Eisley. But this is a really, really cool map because it uses a lot of custom models, as do all of Renz's maps. As I mentioned, Renz also made a couple of Coruscant maps, which were originally for the original Battlefront 1, and then got converted over to Battlefront 2. And we'll be looking at those. Those are probably going to be the next ones I look at, because I do want to do a couple of individual maps before I head into some of the bigger mods out there. But yeah, we're taking a look at this map. But yeah, like I said, a lot of custom models. Some of these are reused, like these crates I think are used in Coruscant City and Streets as well. But this, definitely a really cool map. One of the only, actually I think the only Mos Eisley recreation map that actually uses custom models. I think there's a couple other Mos Eisley maps out there. But they just use the stock assets. And I suppose we didn't actually take a look at the Mos Eisley map in the stock game because it wasn't part of the campaign, but we might take a look at that at some point as part of one of our mods. Oops. And another cool thing about this is there's actually like random like civilians and civilian speeders and such like that just doing their own daily thing, going around the city. You know, they don't care there's a big battle going on between the Empire and the Rebels. You know, they're just kind of, you know, minding their own business, going to work, you know, whatever they do here in Mos Eisley. Guess they've got a hero unit. I don't really remember what this hero unit does. Looks like he has orbital strike droids, possibly. Oh no, he has a different kind of orbital strike weapon. It looks like that might just be something you have to fire down. Okay, and that's how his pistol works. It's actually the same kind of pistol, it looks like, as Jango Fett has in the stock game. Obviously, we didn't play as Jango Fett, I don't believe, so you guys didn't get to see that. Let's head down into the spaceport here. And another thing, there is just so many cool things going on in this map. Like, there is just so much background stuff. I mean, you saw the Jawas wandering around, the civilians and their speeders. I think you can jump in those too. But there's also, you know, like Banthas and Dubaks in the city, and you can see ships taking off. Like this ship I think might take off, and it's probably gonna be one landing in here. Yeah, you see there goes one taking off right there. But yeah, it adds a lot of immersion. It makes it really feel like Mos Eisley. It's really awesome. There's just a great atmosphere to this map. I think this is one of Renz's, if not the last map, one of his last maps. So it's kind of unfortunate, but he did spend a lot of time in this. By the way, speaking of Jango Fett, that would be Boba Fett's Slave 1. Oh, and there's Boba Fett. That's interesting that he shows up there. For some reason, it says I killed a citizen. Alright, so let's see if we can get back outside and possibly pull off an orbital strike. Or orbital barrage, as it is called in this map. Once we get out there, we'll see if we can find a big group of rebels, see if we can pull that off real quick. If we don't die here first. I do sometimes like heroes that use guns rather than being, you know, like Jedi heroes. I'm not sure who this character is based off of. But yeah, he basically seems like a kind of dumbed down Jango Fett because he doesn't have the, there we go, let's throw that orbital strike beacon down over there. He feels like a dumbed down Jango Fett who doesn't have like all the extra weapons and doesn't have the, you know, the jetpack and all that kind of stuff because he's basically got Jango Fett's pistol. Oh, I'm actually out of ammo. That's not good. I guess I have to retreat from this battle, and I have to go find an ammo droid somewhere. Oh yeah, there's a oopsie. I didn't mean to do that. I guess we can use our recon droid to take out that rebel that was over there. For some reason, he's throwing a grenade at that. We got one more. Let's see if we can finish this rebel off. There we go. Okay, then we're just gonna blow it up, and we're gonna head back in there and capture that command post. Yeah, I'm not sure where the ammo droids are, but anyways, there's a Dubak, and for some reason, a droid is riding that Dubak. That's a little ridiculous. I think Renz forgot to add, there's a little line you can add that tells units that they can't get in vehicles, and I guess he forgot to tell the droids that they can't get in vehicles. Also, there's somebody sniping me. Oh, there we go. And I don't have ammo. Dang it, I gotta get out of here. I do have infinite orbital strikes, though, so maybe we can throw that down at some of those guys trying to snipe me over there. There we go. And I need to find an ammo droid. There we go, there's an ammo droid. I forgot, you know, like, I don't think most of the heroes who... Okay, now I'm dead. Most of the heroes who actually have guns, I don't think have ammo. Maybe they do. I don't know. It's been a little while. So let's go ahead and play as... Well, that's just a regular Imperial officer. I think these are just stock sides, but kind of reskinned and such. So they're not really that different, and it looks like they took out like the Dark Trooper and all that. But it's probably, you know, same reason as they, the author... just trying to make things more immersive and trying to make it look like, you know, you just have a bunch of stormtroopers just like you would have seen in episode 4, rather than seeing, you know, like dark troopers and the actual like Imperial officers and all that kind of stuff. So I think the author just wanted to make sure that, you know, it actually represents, you know, what it would look like if there's a battle between the Empire and the Rebels in episode 4 in Mos Eisley. So I want to try to find the cantina, because cantina looks really cool in this mod. And there's some neat stuff going on in there, so I gotta figure out where that is exactly. Oops. Gotta pick up a little bit healthier, and then we can try and find that cantina. Alright, so I think the cantina is in the top left of the map, possibly? Yeah, it's been a while since I played this mod, so let's actually take a little detour through the spaceport over here. Yeah, right now we've got a decent lead in terms of reinforcements, and we got a decent amount of command posts, and we're not surrounded at any of those command posts. Although it looks like we're pretty even on command posts, so they're not actually losing reinforcements. But I think my side can hold its own for a little while. Was this where Boba Fett spawned? I think it might be, and it looks like he's already gone, unless that was somewhere else. We're going to decline the hero for now. Don't really need it at the moment. Oh, this is that little console that we destroyed several times in the campaign that was actually missing a texture, and it looks like Ren's actually fixed that texture that was missing in the actual stock game, which is funny. So you saw another little droid, like all those little droids that you see in like episode 4 when Luke and Owen and Beru are like shopping for droids and such. You can find most of those droids in here, although it looks like this guy's stuck. It's an Imperial Sentry droid. I have not seen that before. Oh, Bothan. Oh, and I'm dead. Okay, now I can spawn back over at the cantina, or not, looks like they took the cantina. So we're still even on command post, but if we go take the cantina, I guess can't get in that, okay. I believe you can ride these guys, though? We can ride some of them, I'm pretty sure, because I saw that droid riding a Dewback. These guys aren't even moving, that looks kind of funny. It looks like a model of a Dewback rather than an actual Dewback. Can we order that speeder to stop, maybe? Nope, I guess not. Okay, I guess... Yeah. Alright, let's head over to the cantina over here. There's quite a few rebels over that way, but we should be able to take them out pretty easily. But yeah, I believe the cantina is this... Yeah, like, the cantina is, like, one of the best locations in this map, I think. It looks really nice, because it's not, like, the stock cantina from the actual stock game. It's actually a custom-made model, just like everything else in this map. Or most everything else, but, yeah, I definitely want to go check that out. That's definitely the part of the map that I really, really want to see. I wonder who the rebel hero is, by the way. If I had to guess, I would say it's probably either an EU Expanded Universe character, like I'm assuming this guy is, that the Imperials have, or it's a fan-made character or something like that, just like the Empire. Because I don't know if that's like a real... that guy's a real person, or if that's something that the... Well, not like a real person, you know, but like something that the... author made up for this map, or if he's actually like part of canon or old canon as it was back then. Yeah, now we can head into the cantina, and it basically looks just like it did in episode 4, and there's Greedo slumped over his his booth over there. I guess he's upset because he got shot, or is he waiting for Han Solo possibly? I don't know. But yeah, there's a lot of cool stuff going on here. For some reason I'm not capturing this command post. There we go, I have to be over here. It is a little confusing coming in here, because you see all these people over here, and they're not actually like real, like, real units, they're actually just like models, just to give the cantina a little bit more life. There's a Wookiee over there, and just a whole bunch of different characters. Oh wait, no, that's Greedo right there. Yeah, he's dead. That's funny. But yeah, you can see all these people over here drinking and all that. Let's go into first person so we can check it out even better. We don't serve your kind here. But yeah, it's got all the little details of the cantina from the actual movie and everything. It's got all these characters. It's got the Bith band, you know. This is really neat. I really like all the detail in this map. We got the bartender, and I think is this the guy who got his arm cut off? I think it might be, but I'm not 100% sure. But yeah, really neat cantina right there. So let's go ahead and head back out, and where should we head next? Is there anything else I want to show off in this map? I feel like you can find Docking Bay 42, I think. Was it 42, or is it might be a different number. But the Docking Bay where the Millennium Falcon is. Let's get a couple of teammates to follow us. And let's try and head to the south of the map, maybe. It might be down there. This is a fairly long... Oh, there's that droid riding that dewback again. Ah! Watch out! I got these dumb citizens who can't drive. But yeah, I think the... What was I saying? I don't remember what I was saying. That all that stuff going on over there distracted me. All the pile-ups and everything. But yeah, let's head back down this way. There's a command post over here we can capture. There is an extra large mode in this map as well, where you can have a lot more units, which I think helps because this is a fairly fairly decent-sized map. And this looks like a maybe an apartment complex, and I didn't mean to hit the mouse fire button there. Oops. This looks like a little apartment complex or something like that with all the doors and such. But yeah, there is an extra large mode for this map where you can have a lot more units, which I think probably helps because it is a very large map. Oh, somebody's shooting us from behind. There we go. And watch out for the auto turret, which the sniper dropped. And I wanted to see if I can find the Millennium Falcon here, because I know it should be around somewhere. And this is one of the few models from the actual stock map, and this actually sits next to, the hangar bay, which I think is supposed to be the one from episode 4 where the Falcon is in the stock map, but I think it's in a completely different location in this map, because the stock map kind of takes some liberties and tries to make sure the map is, you know, sized appropriately for gameplay purposes, whereas this one tries to stay true to the actual what it's supposed to look like in Star Wars canon. So it's definitely a bit bigger, and it might suffer a bit in gameplay because of that. The gameplay is not as tight, but it's definitely a lot of fun to just explore this map. And in fact, I might do Hero Assault after this, possibly, if I don't do extra large, the extra large game mode with lots of units. Because Hero Assault I haven't played yet, but it basically puts all the heroes against each other. And of course, heroes can move a lot faster, so we'd have a better chance at exploring everything this map has to offer. So what's over here? This is like some little... Yeah, it's just some little landing hangar bay or something like that. Looks like somebody's got some torpedoes over here or something. That's what those look like. The Rebel are trying to smuggle some torpedoes out of the out of Mos Eisley, and we gotta stop them by capturing this command post. It does look like this map's getting close to being over. I think that might be the hangar bay the Millennium Falcon is up there at command post 7. So let's head up that way. Unfortunately, our allies over here ended up dying because the AI are not very good. Especially if you tell them to follow you, they're definitely not very good at staying alive because they kind of feel like they have to stick to you. And we got another sniper over there, so we can take them out. But yeah, they feel like they have to stick to you, and therefore they don't end up dodging things like grenades and incoming fire as well. So they do end up dying a little more frequently than maybe they would if they were out on their own. So I think this might be the entrance over here. It's a couple of winding hallways. And I see the hangar bay coming up. Let's just see if this is the one. And there's another one of those Imperial Sentry droids that's stuck. And watch out for that Bothan. Those guys could have been dangerous if I hadn't been watching out. But yeah, another one of those Imperial Sentry droids that seems to be stuck. So that's kind of weird. Yeah, here we go. Here's the Millennium Falcon. I believe this model is also in the stock game. This is the one we saw in the Hoth mission. So nothing new there. You can't actually enter the Millennium Falcon. There's no interior model. That would have been a lot of work to make something like that. I don't think there are any maps where you can actually get inside the Millennium Falcon, except for ones where you can actually fly it, but you can't actually explore the interior of it, because that would have been a lot of work to do. A lot of custom modeling, which can be fairly difficult, especially if you're just modding a game. You're not actually being paid to make your own game. You're actually doing it on your free time and all that kind of stuff. But yeah, we captured that, the hangar bay there, and our enemies are down to only 4 units, but of course we have this huge map we have to find them on somehow. Looks like some of our guys are already heading over to Command Post 1, and it looks like they just captured back Command Post 0, which is where I was just a little while ago. So let's see if we can head back that way, and possibly get it back, or just find the remaining rebels that are hanging around somewhere. Let's get a couple guys to follow me. I keep confusing these civilians out here for rebels, because they kind of look like them. And there's that droid over there. Let's go ahead and see if we can get on that dewback, actually, because I haven't actually ridden on one of those yet. Dewbacks are kind of slow. They're a lot slower than riding any other vehicle, but it can be kind of fun. I'm sure if you actually were into role-playing or something like that in Star Wars Battlefront, which I know there was a bit of a community for that at some point Because I remember I used to be, when the online servers were actually still active, I could go on and see a lot of servers that are like role-playing servers and such like that. I feel this would probably be a good map for role-playing on if you did that. And there's a downed LAAT from the Clone Wars, which is hanging out over here for some reason. Wonder if this is like a junkyard or something like that, and someone brought that in. So we're trying to find that dewback I just saw. There it goes. We'll lose our companions here when we jump on that, because they won't want to follow us anymore, but we can give it a shot, see how it rides. Yeah, as I said, really slow. I mean, I think it uses the AT-AT walking animations, possibly. So it's going to look a little wonky. But anyways, that's the end of that game mode. So let's go ahead and try out another game mode on this map, and then we'll end off this video and take a look at some other maps next time. Alright, as promised, I wanted to take a look at the Hero Assault mode, because using heroes, especially like Jedi heroes, allows us to get around the map a lot faster. So let's play as the hero side of the heroes, and let's play as somebody we haven't played as yet. Aloy Sakura, I don't think we had a chance to play as... Actually, we know we did. We did play as her in the campaign. We played as Kainamundi in the campaign. Mace Windu, yeah, we played against most of these Jedi in the campaign, except we haven't played as Luke yet, I don't think. And we haven't played as Han Solo, Chewbacca, etc., and Princess Leia yet, because we played in the Empire side in the Galactic Civil War. So let's go ahead and play as Luke, and the goal of Hero Assault is basically just to get to 180 points, which is basically the same as Space Assault. I don't really like playing this mode offline, because the AI has a tendency to spam saber throw, and if you get in a saber fight with an AI player, they actually have priority over you in terms of like knockback. Like if you get in a sword fight and they knock you down, you're actually down for a couple seconds, whereas if you hit them, they're only down very temporarily, for only like a second or two. Yeah, like that. Like basically, I hit him at the same time as he hit me, but he gets priority, so his attacks actually knock me down, whereas my attacks basically only do damage with a little bit of knockback. So it's kind of silly. You really do kind of have to rely on your saber throw and stuff, but the AI will throw their sabers constantly. It doesn't really feel like, you know, like a proper lightsaber duel, because they're throwing their lightsabers constantly. And it feels more like, you know, like, I don't know, because it's their ranged weapon, and they see you're at a range, so they use their ranged weapon to kill you. And obviously that's the most efficient way to kill someone, but it just looks kind of silly, because you don't see, you know, during lightsaber duels in the movies, you don't see characters just throwing their lightsabers willy-nilly at each other. By the way, for some reason you can block a force push with your lightsaber for some reason. Let's see if we can try and kill some of these guys, and then I'm probably going to see if I can explore any areas of the map that I haven't seen yet. I'm not sure if there are any or not. But yeah, we're basically getting in a saber throw fight. General Grievous is at a disadvantage in terms of saber throw fights because doesn't have any ranged weapons. But up close, he can probably do a lot more. He can do a lot more damage. But see how they recover instantly from force pushes and all that kind of stuff? Like, yeah, that's what I was talking about. Like, they don't have as much of a knockback when you hit them as you do when you get hit by them, basically. And we got Darth Maul coming at us, and we're dead. Yeah, that constant saber throwing gets kind of annoying. Let's see if we can find any areas of the map that we haven't been to yet. Let's go ahead and play as a ranged character. Let's play as Han Solo over here. And what have we not explored yet? We've already been in the cantina. That's the cantina. There's a couple cool things hanging around here, like a dewback and a bantha. That's what I was looking for. What else have we not seen yet? We haven't seen the top of the spaceport yet, so we might be able to get on top of that. I know there's a way to do that. By the way, ranged characters like Han Solo actually do have a pretty good advantage when playing Hero Assault, because they can stay at a distance and they actually do decent damage, unlike, you know, normal guys like the regular clone trooper or what have you. But yeah, here's the top of the hangar bays. Lots of junk up here. It looks like the Slave One is down there. I wonder if it still spawns Boba Fett in Hero Assault mode, because that'd be kind of confusing, because I feel like he'd probably attack both sides like he seemed to do in the regular Conquest mode, in which case it'd be kind of weird because, you know, Boba Fett would probably be attacking himself. But hey, it happens. Anyway, there's not a whole lot to see up here. The AI, I don't think, can get over here because there's not actually any objectives up here. And also, due to the limitations in the game engine, you can't actually stack AI pathing. So you can really only have one layer of playing field, basically, because otherwise the AI won't know how to navigate, you know, areas up top. So we've been in the spaceport. I think we've been over here. I think we've explored most of the map. So I'm just gonna do a little bit more hero assaulting here and then I'll probably end the video off. I don't think I really need to go through the whole 180 points, because that could take a while. But yeah, we'll probably do some Hero Assault in other maps later too. But yeah, there's Jango Fett. He's basically, like I said, he's got the same pistol as the Imperial Hero that I played as earlier on when I played in Conquest mode. So that's kind of weird, but yeah. But as you see, Han Solo is actually pretty decent. I mean, he's a lot better in Conquest modes, when he can basically, if he gets off that burst fire, he can basically one-hit kill, by which I mean hitting all those burst shots. He could kill infantry units with one shot, basically. So yeah, that's pretty nice. So he is a pretty decent, good hero. He's also got depth packs and rally, and he also got a fusion cutter for some reason, so he can actually repair vehicles and such. And for some reason, I feel like Chewbacca also has one of those. But yeah, I think we've shown off just about everything. I'm trying to get up top here, see if I can spot any areas of the map that we haven't explored yet. I don't think I really checked out the Imperial outpost over here. I believe that's where I spawned when I played Conquest mode. I was trying to see if I could get around through one of these gaps in the wall, but it doesn't look like I can. Oh, there's Boba Fett. Yeah, it does take a couple shots to kill your enemies when you're playing Hero Assault mode. And we might die before we get over there. Oh, never mind. Luke saved us a little bit there. We're going to go ahead and check out the Imperial facility over here. Again, this is all custom models as well. None of this was in the stock game. Oh, we got some enemies coming up on us. Let's see if we can at least go inside and check it out. There's a couple security cameras. They're actually just static images. Those aren't real. Like, they don't actually show you what's going on out there. So, you know, because that would have been pretty difficult to actually pull off. And I'm just going to try and get out of here as quick as possible, because I got a lot of guys after me. And they're all throwing their lightsabers and all that kind of stuff. So, yeah, I'm probably dead here. There we go. But, yeah, I think I've showed off this map as much as I can. And Hero Assault can get kind of dull if you keep going forever. So, I think I'll end it off here. And I'll see you guys in the next episode. I'll probably check out Renz's other maps, Coruscant City and Coruscant Streets. Until next time, see you guys then.